Do you want infinite god level Minecraft armor, tools, and weapons in survival Minecraft? Because that's what the base I'm about to show you will provide you with. Using this machine, you'll not only get rich practically immediately, you'll run the entire server's economy. If you want to see exactly how I make all of the stuff necessary for this, you're going to want to stick to the end of the video. Also, if you'd like to play on the server I made this on, maybe even find the base I made itself, join play.maritimemc.net. It's a really amazing Lifesteal SMP Minecraft server, and I am on here all the time. Let's get to it. Ladies and gentlemen, okay, this guy is standing right in front of me. Ladies and gentlemen, today we're gonna be building one of the best bases in Minecraft. The last one of these I did was when I made a massive sugarcane farm base and made a ton of money off. But now we're gonna be building something even more ridiculous. I'm gonna make a base that can fucking manufacture god level armor and god level tools and weapons. Now, with recent updates, things are gonna make it a bit more difficult. I'm specifically referring to the fact that I can't get villagers trading prices down very much, but it shouldn't matter in an insane amount at the end of the day. It's just slightly annoying. We'll make do though. First things first, as always, we're gonna have to grind a little bit. Let's get to it. Diamond number 1, 2, golden apple, deep dark, warden, 3, I will absolutely take down these coordinates, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, mob spawner. Well, would you look at that? 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, and we are done. Right now, as always, we're gonna have to get really far out. Oh, hey, look, it's one of these new biomes, or what are these called? Mangrove swamp. All right, we're in a mangrove swamp. Let's get some wood. Oh, hello there. I did not realize that slimes could spawn in mangrove swamps. That's kind of cool. These are gonna be useful, actually. I guess this biome is gonna be useful, too. We're gonna need some slime balls. Let's go yoink some of these. Perfect. 8 slime balls. Not too bad. All right, I'd say that we have enough wood. Now let's mine down and actually make our base. That is water. Oh, hey, a little cave. Oh, hey, a big cave. Run, 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 run. Skeleton, skeleton, skeleton. Whoop. Nice. You know what, dudes? I'm in the mood for a weird type of base. Let's just mine this entire f***ing wall out. And then, it's gonna be, like, weirdly connected to this cave. Here, I'll explain it when it's done. Done. All right, now it's time for, like, a little wall. You know, separate out, the deadly cave from my supposedly safe base. So we're gonna have to do that. I'm gonna try to think of a design that I wanna go for here. So hold on, can I not turn this into fucking oak logs? Are you kidding me? Oh my god, okay. All right, well, I'm gonna have to get some more oak planks because we don't have any apparently. Okay, this works. All right, now we have a ton of oak. Although I think I'm just gonna use half for now just in case I need those later. Okay, so for this little wall here, I think we're gonna need some fences for sure. And then also we'll grab some cobblestone because we are also going to need some cobblestone wall. So let's get fences first. All right, I got a ton of fences, probably too many honestly, but it's all right, the more the better. Okay, so first things first, we're gonna need to make our pillars across it, and I don't really want to use this oak log because it's got more functionality than the mangrove roots, which are basically just oak logs with no functionality. So we're gonna go every three or so blocks. We're gonna start here, three blocks there. One, two, three, and we're gonna go up like this. Perfect. Three again, up three, three, three. And then that's that. So now we have this. I think I'm going to do maybe something like that. And then the rest would just be like this. Not horrible, not horrible. I think we're gonna need trap doors at the top though. I think that'll really add a lot of spazzazz, if you know what I'm saying. And then we'll also like have a little iron door or something right there. All right, looking good. Let's grab some trap doors. All right, 40 should be enough. More than enough, actually. Actually, 40 might not be enough. Oh shit, it's not. I might have a little extra wood in here. We have 5 oak planks. Let me see if I can get some more. It's 19. I don't think it's enough. I think we need like 23. Damn it. Okay. I'm just gonna go mine a ton of wood. Okay. Now we're just going to take a bit of this, not very much at all, and then just get like some trap doors. All right, let's put this back, and then we're gonna go place these. 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect. Okay, I think that's looking quite good. Now, the next thing is to make sure that no monsters can get in from the top. It's a good thing we have a lot of oak fences, because we're going to need to place these along this. This way, any mobs spawn up here, they aren't going to be able to, you know, jump down and get into my base somehow. All right. I mean, you also need to close these, by the way. Looking good. All right, I'm liking this. Now we're going to slap a door in the front there. Good stuff. Okay, that is a creeper. Oh god, stupid f***ing, I can't take these. I just talked about it in a stream yesterday. The spiders with like the invis, and they're like, they're only showing their eyes. They're f***ing annoying. Like, why did they have, why did Mojang have to add effects to spiders? They're already stupid enough. Anywho, I think we can do a little bit more work on this wall here. We're gonna add some pillars that are going to the top there. Okay, looking good, looking good. Maybe we'll just add some like horizontal supports over here. Now it's just a matter of actually lighting it up. I think we're gonna use horizontal wood for this. It's a little tad bit annoying, but it's fine. All right, ladies and gents. So this is the old base, and I am really liking the way it looks. Okay, so unfortunately now it's time to deal with villagers. If you've watched this channel previously, you'll know that I fucking despise villagers. They're always trying to haggle their prices, they're inconsiderate, and they never go where I want them to go. Oh my god, we're here. It's this hole right here. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Let's just get this over with. Ready? 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 Boom. Oh, there we go. Perfect. All right, now we just got to follow this guy down here. How did he die? Oh my god, no. Jesus Christ. Okay, now we're going to have to go back to the stupid village, get another villager, but this time it's not going to die because we're going to have a little bit of, we're going to have a few precautions here, so it shouldn't be able to die. Hey, let's go. He's alive. All right, now we just mine this. Hopefully he'll get out and, you know, actually be a good villager. Perfect. Farmer villager. Now we can place down this stuff again because we're going to get another villager. You know what you can do if it's night? You can, like, get them to track two beds. And it usually works quite well. Okay. Why are you not running to the f***ing bed? All right. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to mine out this stuff. Perfect. And we're just going to go over to this little hole here. All right. And then we're going to drop this guy down into it. Break this, drop him down there, and then we're we're going to mine out this stuff. Hopefully this guy is, how the f did you get out? All right, perfect. This is looking really good. Oh, the guy got out because I had a bed here, by the way, and he could just literally jump over it. But now things should be a lot better. Nothing can get out. Also, as you can see, I've done a little bit of work on the base. Not an insane amount. Well, actually, kind of an insane amount. You want to know how I got the grass down here? Because I definitely don't have a silk touch pickaxe. I mined a staircase to the freaking overworld area, and I got the grass to grow down here. It was freaking hard, but I'm happy I did it. We now have grass. Yay. Okay, so the next step in this whole process is to make a villager breeder. We already kind of have one here, but we need an infinite villager breeder. And to make that, we're gonna need one more villager. So I need to wait until these two have a baby. Hey, they fricked. Now we have to wait for this little bitch to grow up. And now we have three villager. All right, so I think right here as well is where I want my actual villager breeder to be. This wall along here. So I'm gonna need to mine that out. Done and done. Let's light this area up a little bit. All right, now we're going to need to make the villager breeder and then transport all of these three villagers into it and put them in their correct places. Perfect. All right, now we gotta plant the carrots. All right, now we need to go over here and mine this whole like little area right here out. We're done placing the blocks, by the way. I just finished it. Perfect, we're done. We're gonna need to get some trap doors here. Place them all along the top part of the block, and then we're going to need to close them like this. Put some solid blocks right here. And we'll need a trapdoor right there. Fence. Now we need to add the beds. You just place four like along the sides here. And then also we want to make sure the corner part of the, or the corner is the pillow. There we go. Done with it. And so with the whatever f***ing update we're on now, 1.19 or whatever, I think it was actually probably the 1.17 update that f***ed everything up. But with that update, I think what you have to do is actually this. Instead of what we had earlier, you need to have just trapdoors kind of over top of the beds. And then we put this one below. All right, looking good. So the villagers still won't be able to jump out, but this time they won't be able to get out on top of the beds. That was the issue that I had a little bit ago, because I made this on my own survivor world once. All right, so all we need to do now, oh, we need slabs. I'm gonna place those here, here, here. And then the villager drops down, baby villager will drop down off of this, gonna flow in a water source that's here. And then the little bastard gets over to here, and there's gonna be some sort of like area where we're gonna keep these villagers in and make sure that we get the trades exactly how we want them. So yeah, we're gonna have to build that too. But now the next step with the villager breeder portion of things is to actually get the villagers in there, which is gonna be tough. So I'm just gonna cut that and I'll get back to you when they're in there. All right, so the villagers are now in there. So here, wait, let me go show you that they're in there. Yep, villager, and then the other villager's asleep. I don't know why this guy's not sleeping. It's actually kind of concerning, but whatever. I'm sure he'll sleep eventually. So now that the infinite villager breeder is done, we're gonna have to work on the actual trading hall, which is essentially the hard part. This trading hall is incredibly time consuming to make, and it's even more time consuming to get the villagers in there. And we're also gonna need a lot of emeralds for this. We're gonna use clay to get emeralds though this time. All right, so you may notice a little something's different over here. We got some powered rails that lead down into somewhere that's, you know, mysterious. So if we go down this little pathway in the villager breeder, I don't know why I put it there. It's kind of inconvenient, but whatever. You'll see that we have a little room down here. So let's take out a lectern. We're gonna press this button here, wait for it. And if we go ahead and press this little button right here, what should happen is a villager should appear in a minecart. We get whatever trade we need to get with this guy. I'm not gonna actually, you know, get a trade, but come on, dude, come on. Why are you just so stubborn? All right, there we go, it's finally where, oh, we actually got mending there. I mean, it's for a really bad price, but let's assume that we want this guy. All right, you know, we trade with him. I don't have any emeralds on me, but we trade with him. And then you click this button to send him off. And then if we just run over to here, there he is. I'm actually just not even gonna bother with this guy. 38 emeralds is way too much. But yeah, that seems to work pretty well. And it really doesn't take that much effort. Like, you just sit there breaking and replacing a single block for a little while. Really not too much work. Yeah, that's the gist of what we have so far. All right, boys, now it is time for the actual hall. We got our little cell here. Now we have to mine down a block behind it. This is where our little zombie's gonna stay. Looking good. All right, now we're gonna need to put the zombie in there. I'm actually gonna need some name tags as well. We're gonna need just the one. Then we're gonna use this, call him. All right, now we gotta find the zombie, which shouldn't be too complicated. We do live in a fucking cave. Oh, hey, look, there's one right there. Oh, you little bitch. Come on, follow me. All right, this way. Good sir. All right, we're gonna go down here. What are you doing? Now we just gotta name him. Not super complicated. Now we have to go make a piston. If there is one thing in this world that I hate, it's pistons. There we go, piston. We need a slime ball or several. We make the sticky piston with the slime inner. We also need a lever. There we go. Now we need to make sure that this guy is, you know, trapped and is not going to kill me. There you go. Perfect. Redstone right here. But there we go. So then we're going to go over here. We're going to craft some slabs. One goes here, one goes here, one goes here, one goes here. Then we need a lectern. God damn it. Why do I always need stuff that I don't have? Looking good. Motherfucker. I just realized I actually need observer. I need lots of observers as well. So we're going to need to go get quartz. Okay, this is fine. We're just going to go. We're going to go get some. Nether, here I come. All right, we got quite a bit of quartz. Now let's make an observer. I think it's like 2 redstone dust and then maybe it's cobblestone only. That'd be annoying. Let's see if it works this time. 2 redstone dust. Yeah, it is. Whatever. So I believe it goes like, no, it's not like that. It's like, oh shit, wait, zombie's gonna get out. Oh, never mind. We need string, which is honestly a pretty easy thing to get. We need another sticky piston, which is really annoying. I hate getting sticky pistons. It's so frustrating. I think at the end we need a total of 3, and we've already made 1. So let's make just 2 more, just like that. And then we're going to need the sticky part of that, obviously. Sticky piston, okay. So now this would be, let me see here. So like that, and then the sticky piston would go there. We use some glass here to put that there. And then I think I need to go a lot higher with this ceiling, actually. Oh, that's frustrating. Great, well, that's done. Also, I did this wrong. Let's put this here. There we go, that is right now. Now we need another observer. So put that there, there. Let's go grab another observer. All right, based on my calculations, it's looking like cell number 1 is done. Now to test it out, we're just going to activate, let's do this string. Okay, that's good. That's exactly what it's supposed to do. Perfect. And then it pulls that block away. Yeah, I mean, it's looking like this is working perfectly. Now we just have to, you know, copy this over several times. Let's get it done. That's right, ladies and gents. We are fucking done. And yes, that took a hell of a long time. Let's test it out. We're gonna get a good villager here. All right, we got the guy. Now we just, do this over and over again until we get one that we actually want. Preferably, it should already have like a decently low price. Okay, so this is prop 4. You know what I just realized? Number 1, this is too high. Number 2, we need emeralds so we can like actually trade with these damn people. So let's get clay guy here. I don't even have enough clay. We're gonna go, I took down the coordinates of a few different lush biomes, so we're gonna go to one of them and we're gonna get a ton of clay for this. Yay! A clay moment. You think that's enough? All right, back to it. All right, Mr. Clay Guy, you are up. There we go. Let's just get tons of emeralds from that. We didn't really get tons of emeralds, not gonna lie. But yeah, you're good to go. Let's see this guy. Let's see if this thing works. I heard some pistons. Come on, please be in there. Oh, yo, let's go. Now the one thing I forgot to do was actually put the, you know, stone cutter thing there. All right, we're gonna have to be really fast. Boom. Oh shit, why are you here? Come on. No. Okay, apparently it's annoying. How do I get you to move? Because you're kind of like not where I want. I don't want to hit him, but this is really annoying. Perfect. Okay. Although, you know, we might as well just kill this guy now. No point not to. Okay. So I also want to, okay. Yeah. You're not ready for more emeralds. 16 should be enough. Cause I think a lot of the villagers, librarian villagers have a trade for 9 emeralds, which we can use. Oh wait, I heard him dying. Okay. There it is. Yeah. He's dying. Shit. Speaking of, we're going to need weakness potions as well as golden apples. Let's get those done now. Okay, now everything should be all brewed up, and we're gonna go buy some golden apples. Let's see where the hell these are. Perfect, $4,000. Easy dubs. Now we're gonna cure you. Good stuff. Now we're gonna go back down. Or wait, yeah, we're gonna go back down and we're gonna get another villager. Let's get one. Fantastic. Now you, my friend, must become a librarian. Thank you. All right, I'm breaking 3. And luckily, we can buy a bookshelf from this guy, lock in this bad boy's trades, and then we're gonna go get a name tag and we're gonna name this bitch Unbreaking 3. There we go. I'm so fancy. I used Roman numerals. Perfect. Now we send this little guy on his way. Dude, come on. This guy would have been so much cheaper. I might actually just go kill that guy up there or something and then I don't know. 8 emeralds doesn't sound like a lot, but it adds it. Yeah, let's go fuck that guy up there. Because he's currently a zombie villager, I think. So we can just kill him and not have a deduction with any other villagers. So we'll do that. Perfect. And then you, my friend. Oh, four emeralds, four. That's great. Okay. So anyways, with this guy, we are gonna... Yeah, okay. It's all set up now. Let's go lock in the trade downstairs. Oh, shit. We don't have enough emeralds. Well, that's not good. Luckily, though, we have enough sugarcane. All right. Trade locked in. We can just put that in there. And we're gonna send you on your way, my friend. And we're also gonna have to murder that guy as well. Turn that guy into a zombie villager. Thorns three. That's not a bad one for this price. Let's get books. Mind that. Grab thorns three. Send you on your way. Dude, holy shit. 18 emeralds for sharpness five. That is ridiculous. Hold on. Let's go grab some more emeralds. I think that's the lowest sharpness five I have ever seen. Sharpness five for 18 emeralds. That is amazing. I love that. Okay. This is actually kind of cool. What the f***? It's an elevator, literally. I kind of like that. Okay, yeah, well, we can destroy these. This actually probably means that I need to refill the dispenser that feeds these minecarts. There are not infinite minecarts, and we actually, by my calculations, we should have one left. So yeah, I'm gonna have to go refill that. God damn, these good trades just keep coming in. 12 emeralds for mending. That is like one of the lowest I've seen. This is exciting stuff. Mending book, 12 emeralds. Easiest thing I have ever done in my life. Now we're gonna name this guy Mr. Mending, the best villager ever. Mending villager for the win. There you go. Now we're gonna send you on your way. Perfect. Now we're gonna get another villager. Hopefully we get like a prop 4 guy here. That's what I'm kind of looking out for, is just prop 4. All right, ladies and gents, 35 emeralds for prop 4. Let me think. What would that knock? That should knock it down in probably the 20s, realistically. 20 emeralds for prop 4. You know what? No. We're better than that. All right. I'm going to take a pass on that one, and we're going to go for a little longer, and we're going to get something better. Okay. Hold on a minute. What are we thinking about this? If I took this, it would be like prop 4. It'd be like prop 4 for 2 emeralds, which is still really good. Damn it. Okay. I gotta get prop 4. I can't settle for prop 3, bitches. All right, we're gonna go all in here. I don't care how long it takes. We are getting what we came for. All right, ladies and gents, looting 3 for 20 emeralds. Not bad. I will absolutely take that. Let's put that guy over there. Okay, I think this is pretty good. Depthstrider is decent. We're gonna send that guy off. All right, boys, we got one slot left. It's basically get prop 4 or nothing. Like, I can't really get anything else. Oh wait, shit. Actually, oh no, I need to kill two of these guys. And I'm thinking about you. I'm thinking you two. All right. We're going to kill those two guys. Just because we need, well, number one, we need a weaponsmith. And number two, we need an armorsmith. Those are essential. So we have to kill those two. And then we're going to add back a prop 4. I'm thinking about building another cell like right here. Not 100% sure about it though. We don't have a whole lot of wall space. Okay, motherfucker. So I have, fixed this. Okay, let's go get another guy. We're going to lock you in, Mr. Featherfall. Four, thank God. I love feather falling. Feather falling four is fucking amazing, dude. Fucking prop 4, 40 emeralds. Fuck you. Okay, I'm not even that desperate. Holy shit! Oh my God! Okay. You know what? No, it was fucking worth it. All right, it took like an hour to get this prop 4. All right, but totally fucking worth it. All right, no regrets at all. Totally not a complete waste of time. I am so freaking happy right now. Jesus Christ. Oh, let's go. All right, buddy, I'm gonna send you off. Okay. Also, I need my name tags. Let's get prop four guy going here. Prop 4. I don't know why this prop 4 guy got off on this one. That's kind of, oh, this is broken. Okay, we gotta fix that. That's fine. Doesn't really matter that much, but oh wait. Kick ass, my dude. All right, ladies and gents, this is going very well. Dude, the chat right now is fucking weird. Somebody just asked what No Nut November was, and nobody wanted to explain it to them, and it's just really fucking awkward. Funny as shit, though. Anyways, it's time to cure this bastard and wait for this guy to die. Now, here comes the easy part. We don't actually have to get the enchantments anymore. All we have to do is just, like, yoink a villager or two. So let's do that. Let's get a villager. Don't want this. Instead, we're gonna get a smithing table just like this. Perfect. We're going to buy whatever. We're gonna mine this smithing table. All right, and then we're gonna go place it just like this. And we're gonna send you off. Next, we're gonna grab a blast furnace, grab another villager. Wait for it. Perfect. Wait for this guy to take that profession. That is exactly what we wanted. We'll buy one of your things, and then we're gonna go over to the area again. We're gonna take this, we're gonna put this here. Oh, this guy's ready to be cured. We should do that now. You guys ready? Throw one splash potion of weakness. One, two, three. Perfect. Kill three birds with one stone and three golden apples. All right, now we have a bunch of villagers being cured. Honestly, you guys, I have to say this is going very, very well for me right now. Now, the next step is actually to make an XP farm. You see, villagers, well, enchanted, but when you combine, how the f*** do I explain this? When you combine enchanted books and put them on armor, it costs a lot of XP. And when I say a lot, I mean it costs a shit ton amount of XP. Luckily, I just happen to have $100,000 for no apparent reason. And I need something to spend it on. So we are actually going to spend it on a little something called a spawner wrench. We're gonna buy two of these, $50,000 each. Yeah, each. These things are very expensive, but very worth it. And then we're gonna go make a some sort of XP farm with these bad boys. Shouldn't be too hard. Let's go get it done. Okay, so we're gonna need a mine into the wall. I kind of want this to be like, we'll have a half slab like here maybe. And then we're gonna go mine this way. Okay, so now we have this little area here. We're gonna mine it out. Oh my God, this is, okay, mining shit with like a diamond pickaxe. Or I guess specifically deep slate. Just fucking sucks. Deep slate is just so, it's so slow to mine. I hate it. Okay, so now we're gonna mine into here. I think it's like this. This is how it works, right here. This is at least how I make my mob farms. All right, then we just gotta do the same thing. Okay, now we just gotta place all the, wait, did I do this wrong? Oh no. No, we did this right. We're good. We're good. I'm goated. Don't even worry about it. Call me Jesus, okay? literally just God. No, right there. Okay, this is looking good. Looking good. Perfect. We need more water at the bottom there, but yeah, this looks nice. Now we need to go and get the spawners. Luckily, I took down the coordinates of some spawners that I had seen in the beginning of the video earlier. All right, so I don't really know how this works. I think we just go for it. Oh, okay, skeleton spawner, that works. And then I do believe there's another one. All right, here is a spawner. That guy's not doing me any harm. Oh my God, a random mending book, that's insane. Okay, well, we can mine that. Perfect. We have a skeleton spawner and a zombie spawner. Let's go home, and then we're gonna go place it in here. Yeah, there we go. Oh, by the way, all of these guys are done, and prop 4 for 1 emerald, and everything else for 1 emerald as well. Fun fact. Okay, so everyone, we've got this stuff, a wheat farm, which is unnecessary to the video, and a, what the fuck, okay. A wool farm, that's what it was. A wool farm, which is slightly necessary to the video, not really anymore. Whatever the fuck this was, which, villager breeder or something. And then we have a trading hall. All right, we built a trading hall. I don't even know where the fuck I'm going with this right now. Basically, we've just built a base that can manufacture god sets, literally infinitely. If I haven't really mentioned it yet, this, if I traded all the way through, it would go up to diamond armor. So infinite diamond armor. This would go up to diamond tools. Infinite diamond tools. And then the rest of these guys are just infinite books of whatever the hell. And we've managed to knock down their prices by a ton. Which means that essentially we can get god sets really, really easily. So we already have books that we bought. I want to get like, okay, wait, hold on. Prop 4, mending. Okay, yeah, that is, that's a full god set right there. I'm not gonna get the armor through the villagers, but just know that you can if you need to. It's a really easy way to get good diamond armor. It'll already have enchantments on it, but they're not gonna be good enchantments. It's gonna be like, I don't know, projectile protection 2 or whatever, and you don't want that. So you just use a grindstone, remove those enchantments, and then, yeah, it's pretty simple stuff. All right, so my anvils are down here. Let's start combining. Right on the dot. This is what we made. Now, keep in mind that we can manufacture this shit infinitely. Do you have any idea how overpowered that is? Literally, infinitely, just using this little contraption we built behind me. That's insane. Not only can we do that, we can also manufacture infinite, insanely good diamond tools as well. Now, I didn't get the enchantments for that here because I didn't have enough space, but you can do it. Trust me, you can do it. And you could also get infinite diamond tools through the villages as well, infinite weapons, you know, all that sort of stuff. Guys, this is insane. Now, it did take me a little while to do this because the XP farm I have is not very good. It's just not very good, to be honest. But, like it's quite slow. I feel like I could have made it a lot faster. Anyways, you guys, I think that is gonna be it from me.
Wow, this was a long fucking video.
See ya. If you enjoyed this Been Taken video, why not watch another one? YouTube has literally put its most recommended video just for you on the screen right now. And if I were you, I would click it.